Fill her up.
You're listening to the Gas Digital Network.
I went online to become a private detective. It was a private detective school online, and I paid online. And I never heard from them again. I thought to myself, I either got ripped off, or this is my first case. This is a journalistic podcast, Shannon. We vaccinate our listeners with answers. And I'm going to keep lip-syncing the important questions until TikTok gives me a show. Shannon, how can the moon landing be real if the moon itself is fake?
That's not true, Mike.
Oh, isn't it true, Shannon? You're fake. You're a hologram.
1 in 5 New Yorkers are food insecure. What's your solution for that, Mike?
Fortune cookie. Because that's food and advice at the same time. Shannon, at least have the decency to backstab me, okay? You stab me in the front every time. Some fans can't watch the podcast because they're triggered by our sexuality. And message to those fans, we will leak a sex tape right into your mouth.
This is Mike Vecchione Investigates.
And you're not better than me. Welcome to another episode of Mike Vecchione Investigates. It's week 2 of the baby formula shortage. So if you're wondering why I have sunglasses on, it's because things have gotten serious. There is a shortage of baby formula out there, and we're not afraid to tackle it, even though none of us have children on this podcast, and Gas Digital forbids it. Except for Lewis, and maybe Jay, and Dave, who are on the flagship show here. Us little peons with our tiny shows that are a blip on the radar and that sometimes we get put in the small studio are not permitted to have children. Is this a cult? I don't know. Could be a future investigation. But baby formula used to flow through the streets like wine. And now you can't get it. And women, God forbid, are going to have to start breastfeeding again. And I don't know if they should because it's their body and it's their choice. And we don't want any of the breast milk to leak out like Roe versus Wade. Things are moving quickly here and I can't manage it all by myself. Shannon and Natalie are both Italian women in the booth. They are writing furiously and trying to import the intro, which took extremely long for some reason this time, but women are people and they're competent and they can be astronauts. That's what the media tells us, but an intro cannot play from start to finish for some reason because it imported wrong, which is nothing about the borders. That's for another investigation. Right now, in order to help me to discuss some of the issues that we are loaded with today, it is loaded. If you came expecting a relaxed show, you better shut us off and you better go to Tucker Carlson or somebody who's a little more laid back because we are in your face with things that are flooding the internet and the newspaper. To help me investigate, I brought in none other, porn legend, hilarious comedian, various other talents, been in the entertainment industry, and is an expert in the entertainment industry. Alia Janine is here.
Hello.
Alia, thank you for coming on.
Thanks for having me. I feel like I need to be very serious.
Well, No, okay. We encourage you to be yourself, okay, as long as it's within the confines of the show.
Got it.
But you're... I have to, a little story about the glasses and part of the reason that I'm wearing them.
Yes.
I was at the Stand Comedy Club, one of our comedy clubs, a very fine comedy club here,
yes,
in Manhattan. And I was sitting in a darker area, mm-hmm, of the club waiting to go on. And you come up to me and I'm sitting and you're high and you go, hello, Mike. And I look at you and I'm like, hello. And you go, yeah, Alia. I go, oh my God, I couldn't see you. I couldn't see you, and it's like, I need glasses, and that's why I'm wearing them today. It's symbolic.
It's symbolic, yeah, for the glasses that you actually need.
Right. Well, these are called progressives.
Oh, okay.
I learned that. It's like half stylish,
yeah,
but on the bottom, if I look at my texts or a menu or something,
yeah,
which I can't see anymore because I'm aging rapidly. I'm sorry. It's a variant. If I see, like, it helps me to read.
It's like the mullet of the eyewear.
Yes.
Got it. Got it.
So
party up top, serious on the
right
bottom.
Right. And it puts, like, it puts a little bit of a sexual vibe out there. Do you feel it?
I do. I have my sunglasses too. Mine are prescription because I am blind. I'm blind, so put mine on.
I just think that we turned up the sexy.
I did,
and if you can't handle us, cancel us. Bye. We dare you.
Yeah.
And we're hot now.
We're very mysterious, yeah. I feel like. Yeah.
I feel like people a lot of times can't handle two people with sunglasses. Like one person with sunglasses, they'll keep the show on.
Yeah.
And other times, and for those of you listening, you know, buy a computer because you're missing a lot of eye candy here. We're sexy. And it two people with sunglasses on, do you think that just repels people sometimes? I can't handle it.
It gives you that Men in Black vibes.
Yeah.
That they're hiding something
right.
from you. And maybe we are. Yeah.
And even this is a podcast where we expose things.
Yeah.
We're hiding secrets.
Yeah, because we're trying to get them to expose stuff to us. So we don't want to show them our full hand.
Yes, it's a good poker analogy.
Thank you. Exposing,
hiding stuff, revealing stuff, you know?
Like stripping.
Stripping.
Yeah.
Yes. And, okay, so you're, before we get into the investigations, you are former dancer.
Yeah, I used to do that.
Former porn legend.
Yeah, well, legend's a lot, but thank you.
Well.
I'll take it.
It's getting pretty hot in here.
Yeah.
And, so as that, do you get people asking you, and I imagine that you have people asking you sexual questions, like how to be better in bed?
Sometimes, yeah. If they, you know, get the cojones to actually ask me a question.
I mean,
like
can somebody come, somebody, obviously you have all a plethora of fans.
Yeah.
And some people don't have any, just like in comedy, they don't have any,
they don't know
how to
communicate
social
women
interaction. Yes, they don't know how to talk to women, or they don't know if they're a huge. A lot of times, they're a huge fan and they're overcome, and they don't know what to say,
I've
and they
had
just
that
go
happen a couple
instead
times.
Of going shy and just being like humble, they go super bold.
Yeah, they
because
just
they think
speak
that's
with
what,
their dick.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's not good.
No.
Because it's not good for any social interaction.
No, I also feel bad for them sometimes because they are just letting their dick speak for them.
Right.
And that has to be exhausting to let another part of your body take over your brain and speak for you.
And we're a big mind podcast here.
Yeah.
We talk about the mind and we talk about how to master your life.
Yeah.
And you're not going to do it with any other part of your body. You're going to do it with your mind.
Yeah, you kind of got to do it with your mind.
Your mind.
Yeah.
And isn't the mind the most sexual organ that there is, Alia?
Yeah, it's...
Talk to our incel fans.
Yeah. Yeah, rather not. But there's actually two parts of your brain. You have system one and system two. So system one is like, I believe, like the cognitive part where...
logical.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. The part where you think.
A to B to C.
Correct.
Right.
And then the other part, well, that's actually system two. System one is the part that actually controls you, how the food that you like, the colors that you like, the people that you're attracted to, and that part of your brain has been developed through, you know, adolescence, through genetics, you know, where it's a combination of both environment and, you know.
Genetics.
Yeah.
Two parts of the brain.
Yeah.
Our fans didn't know that because they basically use no parts of their brain.
Yeah, I've had that happen a lot. Yeah.
But if somebody comes up to you and they're funneling it down and they get their blood up and they're asking you for real sexual advice, how can I be better in bed? What do you tell them? Because, I mean, you know the tricks. You're a pro and you're an expert.
Yeah.
And you know how to tweak things and how to do things in order to get the most. And when you go to share that knowledge, what do you say?
Well, it depends on each person.
Or is everybody's different? But there's got to be some. It's like comedy. It's like comedy where it's like, everybody has different tastes, but there's fundamentals to comedy that you have to follow in every genre. Is that true with sex?
Yeah. I mean, having a hard dick normally helps. That's always a good thing.
But how do you get there? How do you get there? I walk in and I'm soft as a little flower or a lily. And what do you say to me in order to get me? Is there some? I mean, sure, there's something that you can say or do or that would get me from zero to arousal.
Boobs.
boobs.
Yeah, you just show them your boobs.
Show them your boobs.
Yeah, it's really, yeah, it's pretty much just boobs.
Do you shake them or is there anything
I could just show them.
Show them. They're that amazing.
I mean, any pair of boobs, guys, or butt, you know, it depends on
boobs to butt.
On what the guy likes. A lot of dudes, sometimes dudes don't like foreplay, but foreplay is important for both partners, yeah. I believe. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, because that helps get the juices flowing, you
kinda
know.
Like partners.
Yeah.
It's like a buddy cop movie.
Yeah.
My partner.
Yeah.
My partner's in the car.
Nice.
That's pretty cool. So boobs and butt and dirty talk.
Do you like dirty talk, Mike?
Somewhat.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you like giving or receiving dirty talk?
I like it when they're directing it at me.
Yeah.
The other partner.
The other your partner is directing dirty talk.
Is directing it at you.
Yeah. What kind of stuff do you like?
Mostly directions.
Yeah. You know. That's good, yeah.
Because I have no sense of direction. It makes me feel weak and it puts them in a position of power.
Well, here's a fun little trick. So if a woman is right-handed...
Tell us a trick and maybe we can make this a clip.
So if a woman is right-handed, she's going to tend to be more sensitive on the right side of her clitoris.
Okay.
And if she's left-handed, more sensitive on the left side.
Right. Okay.
You're welcome.
Wow, right-handed and left-handed.
Mm-hmm.
And if she's ambidextrous, she just goes right for your wallet?
Yeah, that I am ambidextrous, so that makes sense.
Power move. Alia Janine is joining us. And 11 minutes in, this thing has become sexual and hot. But ladies and gentlemen, let me de-arouse you for a second, which is a new word. There still is a baby formula shortage.
People should just stop having babies, it sounds like.
Should we stop?
Yeah, absolutely.
What should we do instead, then? What, if we're not going to have babies and if we're not going to raise children, what are we going to do?
I recommend women to just get hysterectomies. I've had one, and it's been the greatest thing I've
ever... Now, what exactly is this for our fans who didn't go to medical school, which is everyone?
I had my uterus removed.
The uterus gets removed?
Yeah, uterus and fallopian tubes and cervix. That's all.
Wow.
Yeah, they just gutted me.
They removed all of these parts?
Yeah, I still got my ovaries, though.
Okay.
Yeah, still got the O's.
The ovaries, and that's has something to do with eggs?
Yeah, yeah, they hold eggs.
They hold eggs.
Yeah, I probably got three left, though, so it's okay.
Wow.
Yeah.
Glad you explained it. That could have been scrambled.
Yeah.
Egg reference for our vegan fans. So the hysterectomy, you got all your lady parts taken out. Did you donate them? Do they recycle them?
How's thought, it work like, with the science? Well, because it was like they had cancer. So I'm like, oh, do tests on it and whatever and like try to help other people. And they're like, cool. I'm
very
like,
cool.
Yeah, because I'm an organ donor, you know. So if I would have died, they would have taken probably nothing, to be honest.
They would have taken nothing.
Maybe just for science, you know.
For science or for... Would it made you mad if they took your parts and then somebody used them for fun? Off the record, without signing an agreement?
Like my mouth or something?
No, if they took your
like
lady parts.
Oh, okay.
If they took your lady. I'm trying to be discreet now. We have religious people watching.
Got it.
So they took your lady parts and then someone had fun with them.
Okay.
Without consent.
Without me?
Yes, without you.
I don't think my parts would have fun without me.
No,
I think that they were pretty dedicated to me. Yeah, but maybe I don't know.
That's more. We're getting into a philosophical thing with consciousness.
Yeah,
I think.
And like, what has consciousness?
What has consciousness?
Yeah.
And we're not on edibles on this podcast, so we won't get into that discussion.
Okay.
But so your lady parts were removed.
Correct.
And what did they do with them? And you're cancer free, by the way.
Yeah, yeah.
Cancer free?
I mean, as far as I know, I don't know. I haven't been to the doctor since then. So far. So
but you have to go get checkups, though, right?
I mean, there's nothing left to check. What else?
Yeah, but you have to make sure that it didn't spread.
Yeah, no, it didn't. That's why they took it out, so it wouldn't have spread. But I still smoke because, you know, I'm spiteful and petty.
Wow. You still smoke, so that there's a chance.
Yeah.
You got to give cancer a chance.
Yeah, it's like a lottery. You know what I mean? For suicidal people.
And everybody's so like, we need to beat cancer. and you're like, hey, let's give cancer a shot.
Yeah, let's
see. I need to still smoke.
I'm like, let's see what could happen. What could be the worst thing?
Right.
Yeah.
Ever consider vaping? Or
I do that. Well, I have my robot weed. I have like a vape pen for my weed. Right. But no, I've tried Juuling and stuff. I like the real thing.
I like the real thing.
Yeah.
Nicotine is addictive.
It is. It's a hell of a drug.
It's a hell of a drug. All right, guys, I want to take a second to talk about our friends over at rockauto.com. Hey there, auto mechanics and super cool do-it-yourself guys who work on their own cars. I want to tell you about rockauto.com, the online store with every auto part at the best prices. This is your one-stop shop for everything auto parts. rockauto.com has been in business for 20 years, and they make it easy to find the parts you need at the best possible prices. No more talking to counter guys who need to order your parts, aren't really sure what you're looking for, never have quite what you need, and then after all the hassle, will still charge you storefront markups. At rockauto.com, you can easily find everything you need, and whether you're a mechanic, an auto shop, or working on your own car, everyone has access to the same incredible pricing at rockauto.com. So if you're a car guy, right now go to rockauto.com and check out all the parts available for your car. You're going to have so much fun looking at car parts. So once more, go to rockauto.com. No promo code needed, as their pricing is already that good. When you order, make sure to tell rockauto.com that you heard about them on Mike Vecchione Investigates. rockauto.com. All right, guys, let's get back into it. So that's what's going on in your life right now. Anything you want to share with the fans?
I have my
on the road in the city, working,
yeah.
Performing.
I have all sorts of stuff. I have my awesome podcast, How to Do Drugs. I should have you on it.
Okay.
It's a very fun podcast. We talk about drugs, obviously, from addiction and you know, to recovery. It's
from
not
addiction
just,
and subtraction.
Yeah, yeah, addiction and subtraction.
Speech and meta speech impediment growing up.
I have my monthly show at the Stand every second Saturday of the month at midnight. The Hardcore Comedy Show is back.
I've done it.
Yeah, it's super fun. I'm very happy that it's back and that it's at the Stand. And then Zodiac Killers, another monthly show at the Comedy Shop, which is actually, well, this Thursday, the 19th, tomorrow. It's very tomorrow. Cool. I don't know when this
is. It every Thursday? Is it a monthly show?
It's a monthly. So every month we have comics that their zodiac signs correspond with that month. So this month it's Tauruses. So all the comics are Tauruses.
Wow.
And we have an astrology tarot card reader and
that's
stuff.
That's got to
like
be
that.
Hard to book. Really, you have to do a lot of research just to
we
book
did.
That.
Yeah, we did. I have a whole list of everyone's sign. It's also fun to just text your friends and be like, hey, baby, what's your sign?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it tougher to book now because it's Mercury retrograde? Which I know because I live with a woman.
I think that ends around June or
well,
something.
Well, there's a choice. We could go into a hardcore investigation, yes. Which is more of a masculine thing, mm-hmm. Or we could talk about crystals.
Ooh, okay.
Which is more of a feminine thing.
I got
thing,
two
so.
In my bra right now.
You got two crystals?
Yeah, I don't know what they do. I have no idea.
Probably hypnotize men.
Maybe.
Those kinds of crystals.
Those kinds of crystals.
16 minutes in, we haven't scratched the surface. I hope that you are at home, and if you're in need of baby formula, I don't know what to tell you because
don't have
there's
kids.
A shortage.
Don't have there,
kids. Alia says don't have kids. I say have kids and then figure it out. You know, baby formula, maybe we should be, I think that there's a, we're going to get into it because it's more of an investigation,
yeah.
But I just
they
think
they have surrogate women that will breastfeed babies. I saw it on a movie, Mad Max.
Do you guys call those hired guns?
Yeah.
Women who will breastfeed. Mm-hmm. Women who will breastfeed your child, mm-hmm. Better than you can breastfeed.
Probably. Yeah.
It's time to up our game. It's like if you're not going to do the job and you're not going to do it well, we'll have a hired gun over here to come in and breastfeed your children and be able to bond with them better,
mm-hmm.
And then turn the child against you.
Yeah.
And
create
make
a
him,
whole army.
An army of children who want to go to an overpriced college and get a liberal arts degree, which does nothing for
because
you.
Because they were breastfed.
Right.
Unbelievable.
It starts there. People don't get it where it starts, Alia.
No.
And that's the purpose of this show. Yeah. Investigation. Overreactive investigation. What? You get it. Okay. Let's go to the first one, Shannon. Because this is cutting edge stuff and we need Aaliyah's expertise on it.
I'm very excited.
Not the file.
I feel like we were just violated.
I feel like people are intimidated by us with our sunglasses.
That's what it's making.
Should I put my other?
Do you think that?
Should I? Are we making?
No, I mean we don't back off.
Should I put my hood up too?
That's killer. Oh my God, you look like a sexy Unabomber.
Right.
Remember that picture?
I do got some bombs on me.
Yeah.
No horn. That's fine. Thank you.
We can't lobby Shannon, Alia.
Sorry, is that we're trying to resolve this technical issue?
There's just technical difficulties everywhere. Mercury retrograde.
It is. It really is. It's Mercury retrograde. I need to rub these crystals.
Rub your crystals together so that our fans can get aroused and completely shut the show off, Alia.
This is red jasper.
It's red jasper?
Okay, ready.
Okay. Trump Russia advisor Fiona Hill recalls dinner with bizarre smelling Putin. Do you think, does Putin look like he smells?
I mean, his last name is Putin.
Ooh, that is Putin.
It's literally Putin.
That's a great one, Alia. Thanks.
I mean, it was just right there.
You came off with a, a knockout for the first part of the investigation. A former U.S. national security official has described an odd dinner encounter with Russian President Vladimir Putin, who smelled almost like he had stepped out of some kind of special preparatory bath. Do you take preparatory baths?
Yeah, with like jasmine and rose petals.
Jasmine. What's her last name?
Aladdin.
I was pretending Jasmine was a person, guys. For those of you who are comedically disabled and don't understand the show, you take with jasmine and is there some kind of Epsom salts?
You put Epsom salts, baking soda, rock salt, pink Himalayan salt.
Pink Himalayan.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
You get the salts in there.
So what is that? Something with inflammation? Does it do something?
Yeah, it also makes it helps soften your skin, right, and it helps relax you. There's also these great arnica bath salts that are really, really good for sore muscles and bruises and stuff.
Wow. And what are you doing to get all this kind of?
I kill children.
Oh my God.
To get them for me.
We don't judge people on this podcast.
No, no.
We don't judge our guests.
Yeah, well,
we have you in. We don't judge.
I mean, because I send them to the mine, you know, the salt mines, because I want specific types of salt.
Himalayan bath salt.
Yeah, and sometimes they die. So I basically, children die for me.
And the other reason they die is because they don't have enough baby formula.
Correct.
There's a shortage.
And no titty surrogates.
Yes, and there's no surrogates out there. Women willing to step up to provide.
Yeah.
You know?
I would, but like, I'm too busy.
You're too busy to do it? What if you were to sell it like as merch?
Oh, breast milk as merch?
As merch.
I don't know if I have enough estrogen in me for them.
Is estrogen important? Talk to some of our fans who never took a biology course.
Yeah, I mean, I still have my ovaries, so it's still pumping enough out, but I'm also 43, so.
Yeah. Ovaries? Sounds like you're over it. That could be a clip. Shannon, can we go back to the news story? We've got some deep investigations to do. Fiona Hill. You remember Fiona Apple?
She was great.
She was awesome.
She had a new album come out a couple years ago that wasn't too bad. I like it.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I'm done with more of the fruit-based acts, you know, Fiona Apple, because I'm a little...
Carrot Top, though? Are you still...
I will do vegetables. Okay. Thank you for bringing that up. Our fans were puzzled. Fiona Hill, who served as an advisor to Russia under then-President Donald Trump, dished out the strongman during a recent sit-down. Is this out of bounds to go to somebody's smell? He poisons people. He started a war for no reason. He's killing war crimes.
Of course he smells.
But he smells on top of it. It's like Hitler saying Hitler has a small penis. It's like, okay, like, are we piling on to these guys at this point, Alia?
I think it's just projecting and maybe just picking on them.
Yes.
They're already horrible people.
Yes.
Why dig in more?
Let's, he smells bad, and he poisons people, and he's a genocidal maniac.
What's more important, that he smells bad or that he murders people for fun?
Well, I mean, maybe if you lead with he murders people and then afterwards, and by the way, you do one of these.
He smells. Putin. Maybe that's why he's so murderous, because kids used to pick on him.
That's probably true. Bullying. We're against it on this podcast, Alia. Yeah. Thank you for bringing it up.
He was probably bullied.
Yes.
Hitler was bullied, and look what he did.
Yes.
We got to be nicer to people.
I know. He's a great painter. He was just in the command of himself projecting the image. I thought, wow, look at this, Hill recalled.
Wait, but I feel like you missed one part where it doesn't say that he smelled bad. It said
he smelled like a bath.
Yeah, freshly laundered. That just sounds like he smells very clean. I don't know what the problem is.
So it's not that he even smelled bad. She's like, ooh, he smelled delicious.
He's smells great.
And yeah. I would have liked to have sex with him.
But I mean, you look at Lincoln, yeah. one of our better leaders, and he looks like he smells really bad.
I mean, back then they all smelled yeah. pretty bad, I'm guessing.
I mean, he smelled bad. And is Putin better because he smelled better? And Shannon, you have to like explain. Is Putin a better leader because he smelled like...
Biologically, we may think so, that he may be a better leader because he can clean himself. It could be, you know, that other part of our brain.
Evolutionary.
Yeah.
He's evolutionary better. And Lincoln, with all of his accomplishments,
yeah.
he probably smelled like a dumpster fire. To relate to some of the kids, yeah. what the kids are saying.
But we're also looking at different time periods, yes. though. So
does time period alleviate smell? A smell is a smell is a smell over the decades.
Yeah, but things like deodorant and toothpaste have been invented.
I mean, you can make up all the excuses that you want. All I'm doing is smelling a person. And I go, no, it's repelling. Repelling, which is a big word. And that means to drive someone away.
Yes.
I could do that without the definition, Shannon.
That was great.
Could we put it back up? Because I want to see where this article goes. All of this is staged. Little element is this is a performance. Hill also noted that the Kremlin leader's tightly controlled appearance. I took in the suits, one of the finely tailored suits, the way that the little vein pulses out of the left-hand side of his face. Is this woman attracted to Putin?
She wanted.
She's really looking
yeah.
and smelling him pretty hard for to be repulsed by him.
Yeah.
Oh, I saw his little vein in.
So he was dressed how he's normally dressed
right.
when he's meeting leaders. Like they're all prim and proper.
Right.
Just so much starch.
Yes.
Just keeps him upright.
Yeah.
Because that stuff is so boring.
I mean, what did you want him to smell like? Arsenic? I noticed right away that, like the rest of us, he really could have done with glasses because he had. These giant cards, I could read them all, cards telling him who was who and what he should say and things like that.
But that's a power move on his part, though.
Having cards to,
mm-hmm.
I think she's trying to make him out to be a puppet. Good-smelling puppet.
Oh.
The former national security official also recalled how the brutal Russian leader didn't eat or drink, fasting, which I... encourage on this show.
It could also be a cultural thing.
Yeah.
Maybe he doesn't, it's disrespectful.
Or maybe he's worried about people poisoning him. So it's like, if I was
that
in
makes
Putin's
sense.
Presence or in,
yeah.
in Russia at all, I would always bring a dog with me and then I would feed the dog
yeah.
and then see how the dog responded and then I would eat.
See, you know, a fun little trick is that you could just put eye drops in someone's drink or food and it will give them the shits.
Yeah, but that's like half poisoning them.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
making them uncomfortable, but not killing
mm-hmm,
them.
Yeah.
These guys are playing for keeps here. They actually...
they want to unalive him.
Yes. It's unclear when exactly the dinner took place, although Hill told Desert Island Discs it happened while she was working.
That sounds delicious.
As a national and she's a dessert magazine? See, she's giving
Island
this
Discs?
Top level security...
Just an island full of desserts?
A dessert
that
island?
That sounds actually amazing and not brutal at all.
A dessert island publication?
I don't know.
I don't know who did this article. Hill's observations come amid a spare of reports of Putin's health. Anti-Kremlin Telegram account General SVR, SVR, that's Ralph's show, claimed he recently underwent surgery to move fluid from his abdomen. Is it fluid or was this cologne? Because...
From his abdomen.
Maybe he has cologne in his... Could he be that sexy? Maybe he's the best person of all time.
Maybe it also... it's just his pheromones.
Pheromones is another word that it gives off that sexual
mm-hmm.
flavor and
yeah.
women can't stop. They're climbing over each other like Axe body commercial.
Yeah.
I also claim that Putin's surgery and subsequent recovery was covered up using deep fake technology to simulate his presence in videos of scheduling a media meeting with the Russian Security Council. He's going to be a full-blown hologram probably pretty soon.
I mean, well, yeah, because he doesn't want to be unalived.
Yes.
And so that seems the safest way.
I mean, they think they call, when you get killed now, they call it physically canceled.
Oh, physically canceled.
Yes.
I like that.
Last week, the Mysterious Channel also claimed that Putin had pre-recorded footage in an attempt to cover up future surgeries and was planning on using body doubles if need be. He's thinking ahead.
A surgery? Well,
are we
yeah.
going to hate people for thinking ahead?
He's a smart guy,
He's
obviously.
A smart guy. I mean, you scheduled this podcast. Are you a dictator?
No, well, that's
you were thinking ahead. He's thinking ahead. We're the same.
Yeah, and everyone gets a little work done.
And everybody gets a little work done sometimes.
Yeah, what's wrong with that?
I mean, come on. Future surgeries? We're bashing the guy for having future surgeries?
And maybe he, you know, maybe his appendix will explode or something.
Right.
We don't know how his health is.
Yeah, like the bombs that he's using on the
Ukraine.
They're
very judgy here.
Yes, I think they are. In April, Russian investigative outlet The Project reported that the leader had been regularly visited by an oncologist and speculated that he was suffering from thyroid cancer. What's an oncologist, Shannon?
It's a cancer doctor.
Oh, it's all cancer?
Mm-hmm.
So it's not a body part. It's just cancer.
Yeah, oncology.
Okay. Oncologist.
Yeah.
Good to know.
You're welcome.
Well, we got to the bottom of that.
Yeah.
He smells and then...
smells delicious.
He smells wonderful, actually.
Yeah.
They made it sound like he smells. And that's
yeah.
when we started to investigate. But
like
that's
a Russian bear.
Yeah, but we just uncovered it and it turns out
he smells
really good.
He probably takes milk baths.
I would say that,
His skin looks amazing.
And, but it's... Do you think there's cows in Russia?
I would think so.
And are Russian cows different from American cows?
Oh, are they like communists?
I mean, I
communist
wonder what...
Communist
cows? Communist cows.
We would have to ask Orson Welles, I think.
I just don't know even who that is. Is that an influencer?
He was an author of a book called The Animal
You're
Farm.
Going way over our fans'
oh,
heads.
Sorry.
Please, you lost us at book. Let's get to the lead story. Putin smells was to warm us up in investigation.
I'm warmed up now.
And now, Alia, we get to the real juice of it.
Okay.
Baby formula shortage. Two children hospitalized in Tennessee due to a baby formula shortage. People are going to the hospitals now.
Because they should stop having babies.
Two Tennessee children with specific dietary requirements had to be hospitalized due to the crippling national shortage. First of all, if you're a child, should you be having special dietary requirements? Wait till you grow up a little bit. It's like you're five. It's like, oh, I want chocolate. I want chocolate. It's my dietary requirement.
I want candy. Yeah, you don't even know what you're doing, right?
I mean, come on. It's like I want candy. I want candy. Dietary requirement. And then you just got to give the kid all the candy?
I blame the parents, too. Why didn't they get blood work done so when they had a baby, it would be healthy?
I don't know. Blood work is...
It sounds like Hitler, actually.
It sounds like... The children were hospitalized this month at Le Bonheur Children's Hospital in Memphis. Is there a French... Artisan French Children's Hospital
in Memphis?
That
sounds like a lie.
I mean, Memphis. I got to imagine that the doctors are down because it's the South.
New Orleans. That would make sense.
More of gumbo doctors.
Yeah.
Like a gumbo. According to Dr. Mark Korknix, Division Chief Pediatric Gastroenterologist at the hospital and the University of Tennessee Health and Science, there are young children who have health conditions and specific medical needs. Special medical needs. I read that wrong. My glasses aren't doing their job. It's not because I'm illiterate. Specific dietary requirements. Corkin said in a statement, their bodies did not adapt well to the new formula type and they required treatment via IV fluids and supplementary nutrition. Maybe that's where we should go. It's like no more eating. You can't figure out what to eat. There's always choices. Just IV every morning.
It said the ages are 5 to 8. Why are they still on baby formula?
Right.
They should not be on baby, right?
Right. Especially 5 to 8. You found a hole in the story. It's a hole in the story.
Yeah. How are 5 and 8 year olds still on baby formula?
Maybe it's because they had these health conditions that they're supposed to be still intaking formula.
Well, isn't that what like Pedialyte is for?
I don't know.
I think that vitamin water, there should be a vitamin water that solves this problem, but vitamin water is like phones it in.
Well, just food too, certain
yes.
foods, like they have teeth, they could chew
food
broccoli.
Is medicine?
Yeah.
But with their dietary requirements. I don't like vegetables. I don't want to eat my vegetables. Dietary requirement,
it's
apparently.
Like, well,
now.
Eat the broccoli or die, bitch. I don't know what to tell you.
Yeah, and that's a harsh parenting style.
Yeah, that's why I don't have children.
But that's, I'd say, tough but fair. Corkin said experts at the Le Bon were making... Do you trust a French hospital?
I didn't even realize Tennessee had schools or hospitals.
Thank you very much. I thought they did everything off an app. Making multiple...
Or in the backwoods. with moonshine. I thought they solved all their problems with moonshine.
With moonshine and hucking a rocket stuff.
Yeah.
Making multiple substitutions throughout the child's care to ensure that the nutritional needs are met. This can be a complicated and cumbersome. That's a great song.
I love that song.
That song is great. If we could play a clip, we wouldn't be sued for
Seven
copyright.
Mary 3.
Yes, Seven Mary 3. Cumbersome process and is extremely difficult to parents to navigate. That's directions.
Yeah.
On their own.
To the clit or, to baby formula.
Baby formula. It's
way
close.
Past the clit. Way.
It's close. Both children required an amino acid-based formula.
That's vegetables.
Science nerds.
And fruits and stuff.
Fruits and vegetables.
Yeah.
Because they have short bowel syndrome. Ooh, that sounds rough.
That sounds like a personal problem.
A short bowel syndrome.
So that means that their intestines and stuff is short? Or do they not have a butthole?
I think it's that they have to go to the bathroom
all
close
the time.
To each other. Yeah, like no Taco Tuesday for them.
Like they eat it and it just goes right through.
Yes. Short bowel syndrome, a condition that makes them unable to efficiently digest food.
That's every supermodel's dream.
Yeah, to just get it instead of having to throw it up. We'll get canceled for that one. One child was discharged. That might be illegal. Tuesday, while
it's
the other...
totally healthy too, by the way, ladies.
Yeah. While the other remained hospitalized in stable condition after receiving treatment for dehydration and complications from lack of nutrients. Water seems like a good solution, but I think these people are overthinking it.
It seems that they just need to sit their fucking kids down and make them eat their vegetables and drink some goddamn water.
Abbott, whose recall of infant formula, do you think the second half of a comedy team, Abbott and Costello, should be in this business of baby? Could you take him seriously?
Not really.
Like, this seems like a...
He sounds like he should be exploring something.
Abbott and Costello is who I was referencing for our fans too young to think. Abbott, who was the recall of infant formulas made at Michigan plant, has been widely blamed for the national shortage announced Monday. I had reached an agreement with the Food and Drug Administration on how to restart production. I'm a big enemy of the Food and Drug Administration.
I am as well, but now they're just blaming Michigan. This is Tennessee.
Yeah.
Isn't Tennessee all about separation of state?
Yeah, and Michigan is all about
all the states and
giving
stuff.
People dirty water.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Then saying it's clean. So how can you trust Michigan with anything?
Obviously not with water.
No, with water, and then baby formula is the
which
next
you
step.
Need water.
Right.
To...
That's a good thing to uncover. A lot of our fans don't know that, and because they're dehydrated.
Yeah.
Once a court signs off on the deal, I almost said the deaf, which would have brought another kind of fun element to this. And the FDA gives the go-ahead to reopen the problem-plagued facility. Abbott could restart the formula productions within 2 weeks.
Plagued is a serious word.
It is very biblical.
Like, we were almost in a plague.
Yes.
And so they're going to throw that word out there?
Oh, they did it to, sometimes these
strike
news...
up emotions?
Yes, they did it to arouse emotions. I used to arouse because I'm a sexual being.
Yes.
About also claimed that Abbott... I almost said about. I'm misreading a lot of words, and I think it's because of the lack of the baby formula that I should be having, even though I'm in my 40s.
If you're a Canadian, that's how you would say it, though.
I need to have baby formula. If 5 to 8 year olds can have it, I probably need it.
I mean, it has a lot of vitamins.
Yes.
Apparently.
Apparently.
Apparently, we're missing out.
Yes.
Maybe if we start saying we need baby formula, maybe we could get it going.
Yeah, this company is like 4 babies had become ill. 2 of them fatally, that means death, with bacterial infections after drinking the formula made at the Sturgis plant, leading to the company's voluntary recall. You can't put bacteria in baby formula. Baby formula is to, I mean, come on. I mean, is that wrong? Am I crazy? I mean, you cannot put poison in baby formula. It's going to hurt the child.
They had it at Sturgis where they have biker rallies.
I mean, do you think the bikers are responsible for this?
Well, no, but I think maybe because of all the pollution.
Yes.
Maybe from all the bikes.
It seems like you're protecting the bikers.
Maybe a little bit.
Because they're sexy? And you love leather?
I do love leather.
Damn it, Alia.
I do.
I'm
related to some. So
what's that when somebody gets too close to the investigation and they need to be... They need to something themselves.
Remove myself from the case.
Remove is the common word. We're trying to use a judicious...
Expel?
No, it's when someone has to... it's not
void. Is it recuse?
Recuse yourself! Yes, Shannon!
Thank you.
Solid play, Shannon.
you have to recuse yourself because of your, you bikers. Love leather and bikers,
yeah.
And you have to like recuse yourself from this, okay. Because we're trying to get to the bottom of the baby formula thing, and you're defending the bikers.
I'm sorry.
You got too close to it with Sturges. You said Sturges.
I did.
That led me to the bikers, and then you were like, no, go another direction. Go another direction. They're sexy. Damn it, Alia.
But they are kind of sexy.
They are a little bit sexy. I will say that, and I'm not just saying that because they threatened me. As soon as I heard about the contamination at the Abbott Warehouse, which sounds like a improv place to go see
Abbott,
improv.
Yeah.
The Abbott Warehouse.
About plant?
About. I knew it was going to be a crisis, Corkin said. The patients that I treat, they've lost some of their intestines. Wow. They need to immediately absorb these amino acids. They can't have a regular digestive tract that absorbs it. Somebody else, William Marler, a lawyer, that's what this story needs, specializing in food safety cases, told the Post last week, somebody, whether it be about Abbott or the FDA, should have to realize we're stopping production of the formula. I would like a...
the only place that makes this stuff?
Yeah.
In the entire world?
They have a monopoly, which is not just a fun game that our fans play.
No.
But I got to say that I would like a lawyer that specializes in food, in the food contents. I would like to have that lawyer, because have you ever had food poisoning, Alia?
Yes, multiple times.
Me too. And I no one makes a big deal out of it. Everybody just goes, oh, it's unpleasant. It's like, what about the person that poisoned you?
Yeah.
Because I can pinpoint who poisoned me.
Absolutely.
And I want charges brought on them.
Because they're not doing their jobs properly.
They're not doing their jobs properly.
How many other people are they making sick?
Negligence, I think, is what we're talking about here on this podcast. If you're negligently poisoning people, you might as well be Putin coming out of a fresh bath.
Milk bath.
And we're not sure if Russia has cows.
He could be the one with all the formula, and he's taking formula baths.
Maybe that's another great God, Leah, you're killing this investigation.
Thank you.
Even though I suspect
I know the biker thing. I know.
I suspect I know. You're with the bikers. But that's a great thing. He's maybe not taking milk baths. He's taking baby formula baths. And is Putin behind the baby formula shortage?
His skin is amazing looking.
His skin
it's
is
so
amazing.
Creamy and milky looking.
I think our fans are aroused from you saying creamy and milky looking. Let's go to a lighter topic. That got intense.
It did.
And we're not going
to accuse myself.
And you recreate whatever. You accused yourself from it. And I'll tell you something right now. We are three stories in, and yes. This is a hot investigation. Taylor Swift graduates
from
her very first cap and gown at the NYU graduation. And Shannon, let's see it. This is the one our fans have been waiting for, I think.
That's it.
Okay. Well, she did have a cap and gown on. Were you impressed, Alia?
I didn't know she was even in school.
She's not in school. It's an honorary doctorate.
Oh.
Yeah, and don't make fun of it.
I wish I was famous enough to get honorary doctorate.
It worked for Cosby. Okay, Shannon, let's read this story, because honorary doctorates are not a joke, and they're taken as serious as bachelor's degrees here on this podcast. My more like pop and circumstance, I like the Post.
You know, they're so clever.
They really get it. Taylor Swift is set to receive an honorary doctorate from NYU and deliver a speech to the class of 2022. Okay, so this first issue is, let's say somebody like me who had low test scores. Mm-hmm. And a low GPA, couldn't get into NYU.
Yes.
And then I see Taylor Swift with an honorary doctorate who's speaking. And then I go, what the heck?
Yeah.
I couldn't get in. And Taylor Swift is speaking at the
she didn't even have
commencement.
To go to the school.
She didn't even have to apply.
What about the people who actually were able to get
yes.
in and do all this stuff?
And I'm jealous of them too,
and
but
they
I'm
had
more
to
jealous.
Pay, and they had to pay.
Right.
And she just gets one.
She gets a degree.
That's what happens when you're a white lady in America. We get whatever we want.
Do you guys get whatever you want?
Really,
is that true?
It is kind of, yeah. I mean, I also have boobs, though, so that helps a
and
lot.
You use them to your advantage.
I do, yes.
Is it the boobs or the crystals?
Both.
It's the crystals behind the boobs.
Yeah, I'm magical.
And if someone goes to grope you, though, but they go, I was just looking for the crystals, that would be a good out if it was like went to trial.
Yeah, but I have a knife, too. I like that. You have to protect yourself in these streets, Mike. It's very dangerous.
A knife.
Yes.
A knife to protect your boobs.
It's literally in my bra. It's my bra knife.
A bra knife.
Yeah, and then I sometimes keep one.
A boot knife.
Other places. Yeah, I don't like to tell a lot of people.
Yes.
You know, I have to move it around a lot.
You like them to find out the hard way.
Yeah, obviously.
Weirdly, I'm weirdly aroused. Can I get a t-shirt that says, I was stabbed by Alia Janine and I lost 4 pints of blood?
I will absolutely
maybe
make
that's too
you
long
hear.
To put on the front. Maybe 4 pints of blood on the back.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Or just blood on the back.
That's hot.
This is why I design shirts.
Damn it. Wearing a cap and gown for the very first time, you see NYU Swift caption a video posted on TikTok and Instagram, suited up in purple commencement. Should people just graduate on TikTok now? These ceremonies are so long, and we're sitting there, and we have to go to the bathroom because we have shortened bowels.
Yeah.
And it's like we're watching, and it's like this could be a TikTok.
It's what is it? 10 seconds,
yes.
15 seconds, maybe
even
a minute.
But like these. Oh, we have
Let's
to watch
speed
everybody.
It up, people.
And then throwing the cap, it could land in your eye. We can't throw caps
That's
anymore.
That's very dangerous.
Yeah.
You can hurt birds as well.
Yes.
Bugs. There's so many other things.
The environment is supposed to be such a big thing. We're throwing these caps up and killing birds and other insects.
Humans are so selfish.
God, we hate it. Beneath her traditional gown, the 32-year-old, I didn't know she was this old, wildest dreams hit maker, more like a black dress and leopard print pumps, and she posed for photos snapped by her father before heading off to Yankee Stadium in her car.
Was she driving while making that TikTok? Oh, no, she has a driver. She does.
She has a driver, and she was doing it, but is she going to Yankee Stadium? Was she going to throw out the first pitch also?
Another I think that's where the graduation was. Was that where the graduation was for NYU at Yankee Stadium? That's a lot of people.
That is.
And did they have it at Yankee Stadium just because Taylor Swift was there?
She does draw.
She does draw.
It's in the South Bronx, which is a really good neighborhood.
Yeah. Did she sing afterwards? Like, she better put on a free show since she got a free degree. It seems like a good trade.
I think so. She's going to speak, though.
Well, she's a singer. They shouldn't speak so much.
Well, maybe if she just did a speech on her lyrics why all these guys.
Oh, and just spoke them like spoken word poetry. And how? What is she? It's an honorary degree. She doesn't know. Does she even know what her degree is in?
Well, let's find out if it's in something.
Got it.
Swift will be receiving a doctorate of fine arts. There's your answer.
Arts that are fine.
Yes, fine arts. Fine ass arts.
Fine ass arts.
Honors. Causa? Is that a word?
Honor is
Causa from the university, which hailed her. I would like to be hailed as something.
Right? Like God. Hail Caesar?
Yeah. Or Mike Vecchione was hailed as having the best investigatory podcast.
Yeah. I hail cabs all the time.
Yes. Do you think your crystals get you the cabs? Or is
I think,
it your breasts?
Probably my breasts.
And then the crystals are behind it with the other part of the brain.
Yeah, the protective.
The magnetism.
Yeah.
I think magnetism was the word, not magnesium. That would have been...
No, that's an element, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Element of surprise.
Is that MG on the periodic scale?
She will be receiving a degree in fine arts. If you shut this podcast off because you're frustrated with Taylor Swift, turn it back on because we're trying to get... You can't hear us. Hailed her as the most prolific and celebrated artist of her generation in the press release shared. But she doesn't speak to me because she's talking about heartbreak all the time. It's like these guys hurt her and she writes songs about it.
What generation?
Generation Z.
Oh.
Yeah.
I forgot that they were a thing.
They are a thing. Okay. And they're coming. They're really like, they're here now.
Yeah, they're everywhere.
And hopefully they have a replacement baby formula.
Or they could just stop having babies.
You're really big on that, Alia.
Yeah.
What have you got against children?
Have you seen them?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, they want to play. They put stuff in their mouth. they're on the playground.
Children,
and you just hate it.
Well, no. See, this thing, when people say they're like, oh, I want to have a baby, mm-hmm. but that baby grows up to be a child and then a teenager. And then normally, probably an alcoholic. So you just created a another person to take up air and space that just drinks too much and is sad.
What about a great person, though, Aaliyah? You're raising a great person.
Yeah, have you seen it outside with people?
Is that what we're getting to? You don't like people.
I'm not.
You're not a people person.
I mean, I love people, but also there's just too many of us, I think.
But what about the good, if you're going to do a good job?
But
do you think that they should have
a good job?
Yeah, there are some people who do a good job. I've met people who are like, wow, you're really a benefit to society. You're a benefit to the world.
Yeah.
Where are we going to find people to invent baby formula if we don't raise, and you're saying people. Just cut it all off.
Yeah.
We should stop having children and just like let the whole species die out.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Sunglasses have really changed you, Aaliyah.
I know. I'm really dark. It's the hood too, maybe.
It'll be the Grammy's first. It'll be the Grammy winner's first degree.
So
she was already writing hits and heading out on tour by the time she graduated from high. How do you think that makes the rest of us feel, Aaliyah?
Horrible.
Yes.
Horrible.
I mean, she was already killing it in high school.
She was.
What about the rest of us?
Not killing it in high school.
No,
that's for
not
sure.
killing it. I didn't have to go on tour in high school.
No.
I had to go to college, and then I had to get a master's.
I got expelled from high school.
Did you?
Yeah.
What did you do?
I accidentally started a fire. And I turned myself in, so they allowed me to go back to the school.
Were you an arsonist or a pyromaniac?
I was a cigarette smoker, and I flicked a cigarette into a pile of dead leaves, and it just went boop.
Oh, my God. You were a smoker.
Yeah. Back then, I started young.
Wow. Smoking, and were they, what kind of a cigarette? Was it Virginia Slims, which is a feminism cigarette?
I'm a big fan.
It Newport, which is a prison cigarette?
Newport 100s. I've been smoking those for like 27 years.
Wow.
I'm very loyal to the brand.
When do you get, when is your probation up? Send her in the criminal justice system. She's one of two special speakers slated to appear at NYU's festivities. On Wednesday evening, the school will hold additional ceremony of the class of blah, blah, blah. Who's the other person? With disability rights advocate Judith Human, addressing the grads and receiving Doctor of Humane Letters. There's all kinds of degrees now. It's like, can I get a degree in podcasting?
Absolutely.
I'd like to get a doctorate in podcasting.
You know who the speaker was at Columbia? Hillary Clinton.
Wow.
So they had Hillary Clinton. NYU got Taylor Swift.
And what did Columbia got Hillary Clinton?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I believe she went there.
So. Oh, did she?
Yeah, because she has...
That's cheating.
To actually go to school and earn the degrees.
But Hillary, I meant Hillary Duff. Do you think she got a public speaking thing somewhere?
Where did she go? I liked Hillary Duff.
So did I. But, is she the Call Me Maybe?
No, that's...
Is that Taylor Swift? Who's Call Me Maybe?
Rasp, Carly something?
Carly Rae Jepsen.
There we go, what she said.
Oh, Call Me Maybe. I meant...
Ben Howard does a great remix of that.
Call Me Maybe is a great song.
I'm a big fan.
It's a great song. And for those of you out there ready to turn the podcast off because we're not cool enough, go listen to it. Go listen to it. Come back to the podcast and tell me that that's not a great song. Leave your comments. So Taylor Swift graduates, and we're happy that she's graduating in a...
I mean, congratulations.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
But I would like to have... I would also like to have...
We're going to get our honorary
degree. I would like to have an honorary degree.
I think we should... It's going to happen to us. Maybe even at the same time. How cool would that be?
What would you want your honorary degree in?
Psychology.
I would like it to be in superhero studies.
Yeah. Okay.
If it's going to be a fake degree, I'd like it in a fake
would that be,
discipline.
Oh, okay. Because I was like, they have, you know, degrees in like Greek mythology and stuff.
No, I don't want to study it. I want to be it.
Got it.
Yeah.
Got it.
It's like you could be a marine biologist or you could be Aquaman.
Yeah.
What would you choose? It's like, obviously Aquaman.
Yeah, to breathe underwater and like, swim with fishes.
And then subliminally tell all the fishes what to do.
Whenever you want.
Whenever you want.
Unbelievable.
Attack this person.
Yeah.
Be nice to this person.
Yeah. See, I bought drwhore.org, so I just want to get the doctor part down. So the honorary. The honorary degree.
Honorary
really
degrees
help.
Are the way to go, I yeah. think. Degrees don't do anything for you, but if you have an honorary degree, yeah. it opens a lot of doors.
It basically just tells people that you spent a lot of money reading some books.
Yes.
And writing some papers.
Are you talking about a regular degree?
Yeah.
Yeah, an honorary degree is so much better.
You just get
I
a degree.
I skip all that, and yeah. I'm famous, and you will respect me, and I will give
And
a
people
speech.
Will have to call you doctor.
I would make everybody call me doctor.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's why doctorwhore.org.
You know one of my favorite groups is Dr. Hook?
I don't
When you're in love with a beautiful woman, that song.
I don't think I've ever... Maybe if I heard this song, I would know it.
Shannon, can you play part of it? When you're in love with a beautiful woman. It's one of my favorites. And Dr. Hook is another doctor, and I wonder if he has an honorary degree in
Or is
sex
he like and... Dr. Phil and just calls himself doctor?
Dr. Phil's a chiropractor, I think.
Does that count as a real doctor?
Yes.
Dentist, too. Dentist.
Yeah, if you have spine problems, Dr. Phil could probably help you.
Straighten out a little bit.
You gotta, like, talk over it a little bit or we're gonna get flagged.
Okay, yeah, well, yeah, it's
absolutely.
Fantastic.
It's a great
this song.
This song
is the... One of the greatest songs ever written.
Yeah, no, it's beautiful. I've heard this before.
I love
yes.
this song.
I didn't
because,
know it was who.
No, it's really about yeah. being in love with a beautiful woman and the fact that when you're in love with a beautiful woman, everybody thinks it's easy, but everybody wants her.
Yeah, it's hard.
And people are trying to get to her and people are trying to get with her. And it's like you got to keep an eye on her.
It's very animalistic.
Yes.
It's all
And
your
Dr. Hook has a patch, so it's like he's got to keep an eye on her. It's symbolic.
Amazing.
The 70s were great.
They really were.
And we've got a lot of more work to do.
All right.
Alia.
What else are we investigating?
I don't know if you've been following the Depp Heard trial.
A little bit, yes.
People are choosing sides.
Yeah, I already have.
Well, don't tell us okay. because it's going to prejudice.
I know.
It's
gonna prejudice I may have us. To recuse myself.
Yeah.
Again.
Recuse before I accuse. And that's why those words are so close.
Oh, yep.
Scalpers for the Depp. People are selling tickets.
Amazing.
To the trial. And I'll tell you what, I think it's amazing.
I mean, people got to make money somehow.
People got to make money, and I would buy one of these tickets.
And isn't this in some small, what state is this in again? Iowa or something? Idaho? One of the Iowans?
They haven't heard enough. God, I love the Post.
Oh, Virginia.
Fans desperate for access to the Fairfax, Virginia courtroom. Johnny Depp and Amber Heard are locked in a heated defamation. The whole thing is defamation. The whole trial is defaming them both
and
more.
And defecation.
And defecation is the number two. That was my second point. Have been forking over thousands of coveted seats, but now they're even buying them on the black market, turning the orderly waiting game into a free-for-all. Court officials have limited numbers of wristbands to... I wonder if you get a certain color that you could drink.
You're right, just there like you get a free drink.
You get a free drink with
or
the
maybe
orange.
A snack or something.
A snack or...
I like snacks.
I bet there's bathroom breaks since the revelation of her doing a number two in the bed.
Yeah.
There's frequent bathroom breaks. 100 of the main courtroom and an additional 100 to the 50 to the... This should be an arena. This really...
Yeah.
Putting it in a courtroom is a mockery.
This needs
put
to be at Yankee
in,
Stadium.
Yes. Put this at the Beacon or something where there's a lot more seats.
Yeah.
Cheat us like this. Yet many fans don't make the cut. Oh, God. It's probably if you've been honorary doctorate, you probably would.
Automatically. Or if you worked for the court or if you had a uniform or something, you could probably sneak in there.
Well, I would go to school to get an honorary degree in stenography just to do this trial.
Yeah.
Many of the fans, according to TMZ, which is a reputable news site.
Absolutely.
Are rabid. I love that word. Do you
rabid?
Love rabid?
I mean, I like the rabid. Yeah.
Yeah. Because it's like it infers that you have rabies.
Rabies and rabid.
You're a rabid fan. I'm a rabid fan. I'm rabies.
Oh, I thought you said the rabbit. My mind went somewhere else with rabbits.
Hello. A 58-year-old Depp who also has hordes of fans and social media with him. And she's somebody too. Like, don't leave her out. I think that's we drove 500 miles to be here. These are signs.
Wow.
We drove 500 miles to be here. We love and stand with you, JD.
Johnny Depp,
yeah.
For
the Do you think they're betraying their... Their
gender,
yeah.
No.
Okay.
Nope.
Well, wait, not to. I'm glad you didn't tilt your hand because we still have to get to. And there's pictures, and that's Johnny. Johnny's 50.
I learned my lesson the last time.
Yeah, recuse yourself, Johnny Depp.
People began lining up at 10 p.m. Sunday.
They're giving him gifts.
How much
stuff?
Would you pay for a ticket?
I wouldn't do something like that.
You wouldn't go?
No.
If free tickets, you wouldn't go?
Probably.
I call you up. I go, Alia, let's go to the truck.
For this podcast to investigate
stuff? No, not for the podcast. Oh. No, there's no means to it. And we're not trying to investigate it. We're just going, you bring the popcorn. I'll bring the beverages. Let's go to this trial. You tell me no.
All right. Yeah, I guess I
would. Okay, you go. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And you bring the sunglasses and the crystal breasts.
Yes. They're always with me.
They're always with us. But fans have been pushed their luck a little too far, prompting the sheriff to post a sign that reads, Effective immediately, the line for the Johnny Depp Amber Heard case spectators are not permitted to loiter or camp out on the judicial complex before 1 a.m.
Oh, so he's putting his foot down.
I mean, if they're going to do this in this type of totalitarian government, they need to provide an after party.
I mean, these people are bringing money into this town. You know, they're getting hotels and things like that.
And people are trying to have fun.
Yeah. Also, I thought that only people that were in that state were allowed to go to these types of things.
You got
to
be a voter in Virginia?
Yeah. I mean, I thought, obviously, I'm wrong. Can people from other states even go watch it?
Yeah, they can.
Huh.
Thank you for bringing your communist viewpoint
to it,
where it's like only people from the state.
Yeah.
God. Ivan DeBauer, a 59-year-old super fan of Depp, said she used a year's worth of her paid vacation time to come from Los Angeles to the trial to support Depp. That's where he's from. So it's like he's got his own hometown people.
Well, he's from Kentucky, I thought.
Yeah, but he lives in LA
because he's
a big star.
Yeah.
God, these guys got egos. I took my whole year's vacation so I could be here for Johnny, she exclaimed.
That's not mentally healthy.
I'm the same age as Johnny, and I'm single, so I do what I want, basically. She's thinking that she could get with him.
Yep, during this trial with his ex-wife.
Is that a tactic? Everybody's on these dating sites. Shannon, I'm going to bring you
I mean, that's a solid tactic.
Is it a tactic for us normal people?
No.
Okay, so I look up the divorce trials that are going on. And let's say I'm single. Mm-hmm. I go look up the divorce trials, and I go and I sit in the divorce proceedings hoping after this is over, I'm going to get with the wife.
How many
because
people
I know she's getting a divorce. It's all listed. It's a matter of public record. I go to the trial. I get hooked up with good seats because I hit a scalper friend that I know.
Obviously.
And I sit there and I go, baby girl is mine after this is over. I'm going to treat her good.
It would be a good place to go.
Yes.
I believe
and no one thinks about that.
No.
And you're going to get this kind of information.
It's way better than meeting someone at a bar.
Yes.
Meet them while they're getting a divorce.
Getting a divorce.
Yes, and they want to go out and they want to have fun because they're free of that other person.
If you don't want me at my worst, you can't support me at my best.
Yeah.
That's something that women are saying all the time now.
All of the time.
I mean, I usually never listen to them, but they've said that enough times where it's seeping through.
That's fair.
And they can be astronauts.
Can they?
I think they can.
Oh, okay.
According to the Super Bowl commercials from 2 years ago.
Oh. I don't watch football.
The Super Bowl, Alia?
No.
You say no to the Super Bowl.
Oh, I've gone to the Super Bowl.
Did you have an honorary degree?
No, but I had honorary tickets.
You would go to the Super Bowl, but you wouldn't go to the Depp. Heard.
I said that I would now with you as long as we have snacks. And bathroom breaks.
I do fasting, so I personally think that snacks are for the weak.
Okay.
But if you want to bring them for yourself,
I have my crystals.
I won't judge
you. It's fine. Yeah.
No, I won't judge you if you have snacks, but I just can't do that.
That's fine.
To eat I had a big own. Dinner last night and I'm fasting until dinner tonight.
Got it.
Let's do the last one. We're an hour and two in.
Okay.
Alia, I know you're exhausted.
I love events investigating with you.
It's pretty great.
Yeah. I like investigating.
And for some of you, you thought this was all about sex.
No.
And let me tell you what it's not. It's not all about sex. But the beautiful part is if you're tuning in, the sexual undertone that we are both bringing to every story is palpable. And palpable means that there is pulp in it. It's little bits of it around.
And it's some of you want no pulp, and some of you want I like all pulp. And we are some pulp.
I like some pulp.
Some pulp.
You don't want to be pulpy.
It's pulpable.
Yeah, we're like chewing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But do you think, feel that about our sexuality?
Absolutely.
Ever since we both put the sunglasses on,
and
it's
the hood
been very
and
so, yes. thick and it, viscous.
You could cut the air.
I think I confused a lot of our fans with viscosity. They're not used to viscosity, even though a lot of them do wrestle in oil. Okay. Finally, teacher-student sex. It's a story that never gets old.
Oh, and, it's as old as time.
Oh, God, these teachers are so hot.
I mean...
What a sexy teacher. She's from Pennsylvania. Shout out 610. Pennsylvania teacher busted for sexual relationship with student after the husband alerts the principal. What a snitch.
Wow.
This husband
and,
is.
And there's literal
impression.
Laws where spouses do not have to testify against
That's
each other.
That's right. They get to recuse themselves.
Recuse.
They recuse themselves.
Recuse.
A married Pennsylvania high school choir director, but she's singing a different tune now, was arrested for a sexual relationship with a female student after her irate husband alerted administrators.
A female? I've never heard of a female on female.
Girl on girl.
Yeah.
These things are getting hotter.
That only happens in the movies.
It only happens
that I
in
have
the
done.
Movies. This is a porn script.
They just read a porn script and wanted to reenact it. Alia, maybe it's for theater. She's a choir teacher. Maybe that girl's in theater. Let's read on.
thank you for taking over the podcast. First of all, are there scripts in porn, right?
Sometimes, yes.
Okay. So there's scripts. Have you ever written one? Or I wanted to write one?
Yeah, no, for my scenes on my website, I wrote all of those.
God, I would like to write a porn script. I think I would be good.
I think you would be phenomenal.
Olivia Ortz, 26, was taken into custody Monday and hit with two counts of sexual activity with a 17-year-old student at Wilmington Area High School in Newcastle. That's pretty close to where I used to teach, actually, in Pennsylvania. Her husband, who did freelance work for the school's music department, found incriminating messages on Ortz's iPad after coming home from a recent trip to Florida and told the principal.
He was investigating
what?
His
he
wife.
He did. I mean, don't you confront your wife first before you take it to the principal?
That's snitching.
And that is snitching, and that's going to get her fired. Can't you handle that within your own marriage instead of getting your wife fired?
And also, she's into girls. Isn't that a bonus?
I don't know.
Unbelievable.
Ortz of Hermitage was suspended on May 9th. That's my father's birthday. God rest his soul.
Happy birthday.
And a warrant was issued for her arrest on Friday. According to the report, she declined to immediately turn herself in and even sang in a local concert on Sunday before finally surrendering the following day.
Good for her.
She sang anyway.
She's like, I'm going to fucking sing this.
You're
God
not going to sing. You're not going to silence me. Isn't that women are saying that?
Yeah. I think we're big on the, yeah, the whole silence.
Yes.
Thing, yes.
But isn't silence golden? It's a tough one.
It is a tough
but
one.
But not for women.
No,
women
no, because we're women.
Yes. And women are above mantras. Remarkably, Ortiz's predecessor at the school music director, Jonathan Prano, 37, is facing similar charges of sexual misconduct. Are music teachers just more prone to sleep with their students?
Well, I mean, you know, they couldn't make it in a band, so, right. And, you know, band dudes are always horny. Fuckers.
Have you had sex with musicians?
Yes.
Do they, is their rhythm in perfect iambic pentameter?
Only the drummers.
Only the drummers. Damn it.
Lead vocals are horrible.
They're bad?
They just screech.
Do they last like 3 minutes and 39 seconds, the time of a song? I'm sorry. They immediately can only last. All right. Remarkably, Ortz... Okay, we did. He allegedly had an affinity for tickling the feet of co-eds and forming appropriately, inappropriately close relationships with them, according to reports. His criminal case is pending. Tickling a foot is now a sex?
Okay, so...
I mean, you shouldn't be tickling a foot in a school or with kids.
Tickling,
but tickling a foot, is that a form of molestation?
That's, they have... Well yeah, because it's a whole fetish. Tickling is a whole fetish.
Do you need consent to tickle?
to touch. Yeah, I would. Yeah.
Consent to tickle?
Yeah. Consent to touch in general. That's touching. Yeah. So any form of touching.
I never thought of that before, but consent to tickle really, it just doesn't sound right to me.
Does that hurt you?
It hurts me because it feels like you're an enemy of comedy if you go,
laughter.
You need to consent to tickle. It's like, come on.
Do you tickle your audience members? With your words.
With your words. And then I will give them the option for a physical.
Do you charge extra for that?
I would charge extra.
Absolutely.
And then it's even extra if a tickle turns into a massage.
Obviously.
Tips from Ortz's husband, investigators found more than 100 messages between the choir leader and her female student using a Spotify chat function. I didn't even know if that was
I didn't know that was a thing either.
Spotify chat.
I mean, that's smart, though, because no one knows about Spotify chat.
I mean, this husband, who's also a nerd, probably does. I mean, can you save the marriage at this point?
From his wife having a sexual relationship with a 17-year-old girl.
Yes.
I mean, that's normally every man's wet dream.
Yes. Well, 18 is legal.
Obviously, it depends on the state.
Yeah. Well, it does depend on the state.
If she bleeds, she breeds.
Wow. Exclamation point. The girl said she returned to Ortz's home after her husband discovered their relationship to offer the teacher comfort. Wow, that is
comfort.
Authorities said they interviewed the teen and her parents again on Monday the 5th after executing a conclusive search warrant. The teen defiantly told them that the pair were still communicating despite looming criminal charges. Can you just go, nothing happened? Because if you say nothing happened, mm-hmm. and the other person says nothing happened, they have nothing.
Yeah, but she's technically a child,
right?
Legally,
right?
And a lot of times they can't make their own decisions.
They can't make their own statements
when it comes to that type.
But I'm saying more of it was like when there's a male student sleeping with a female teacher, and then
if they
were smart, they wouldn't brag. And then if let's say something happened where it's an accident like this where it was discovered, and the guy just goes, the kid who's a male. Because I think it's a different thing when it's a male and female. Mm-hmm. But if it's a female teacher and a male student, he just goes, no, nothing happened. And they go, well, we have all this evidence. He goes, nothing happened.
You can't prove anything.
So if the female teacher says nothing happens and the male victim says nothing happens, then do they have a case?
I think that has already been out that the case, I forgot.
Mary Kay Letourneau.
Yeah, they got married when she got out of prison. Like, they married, right. They have a whole family. It's a whole thing.
Yeah, but I wonder if he did that because she got fired still.
So I wonder if
that would work, if that would hold up.
Probably not. If the male student
would just go, no. And the female teacher went, no. And then
everyone's just like, no, I didn't do it.
Well, you don't have to break the law for them to fire you. They could just go, we suspect that you're fired.
Well, I mean, the text messages are probably enough to fire somebody.
Yeah.
But if there's no physical evidence, you need physical evidence, no?
Yeah, I think you do. Or else everything just becomes accusatory
with
no solid evidence. And this is a fact-based podcast, and people know that. And
we that's need why they facts.
Watch. That's why they watch and listen to us.
I get it now.
Let's go to plugs.
Plugs.
Put that coffee down. Coffee's for closers only. Always be closing. Always be closing.
I'm gonna have Heidi lick some caviar off my balls in the meantime.
This guy is a wrecking machine. And he's hungry.
Guys, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. Thank you for support. Thank you for your 5-star ratings and reviews. At Comic Mike Me on all social media platforms, at Comic Mike V, MikeVecchione.com for dates. I got a date coming up in Minnesota. It's, when is it, Shannon? It's Minnesota, May 26th through the 29th, House of Comedy. I was just in Arizona, did a house comedy there. It's unbelievable. We had a great weekend. So, Minnesota people, come to the House of Comedy, May 26th through the 29th. I'm there all that weekend. I think that's Memorial Day weekend. So May 26th through the 29th, Minnesota. MikeVecchione.com for future dates.
And please support the show. We're doing great shows. We're hit a stride where we're just killing it. So please spread the word. And I'm going to try to go on some other podcasts when I'm in town to pump this podcast, because we hit our stride and we're bringing in top-notch guests, and every investigation is really hitting hard. So thank you for your support, and we love you guys. Alia, what do you got?
Oh, you can follow me on Twitter, the Alia Janine, Alia.Janine on Instagram, Alia Janine on Facebook, and you can check out my schedule at AliaJanine.com.
Shannon.
When I'm ready. Okay.
Yes!
You can follow me on Instagram at ShannonLee6982. Listen to my podcast, The Thing Is Ding. We talk about bad dates, fighting, and ghosts. Wherever you listen to Mike Vecchione Investigates, you can also watch it live for free every single Thursday at 3 p.m. Eastern. That's at gasdigitalnetwork.com/live. That's absolutely for free. The best way to support the show, though, is to go to gasdigitalnetwork.com, use promo code MVI. That'll give you a 1 week free trial, which gives you access to every single episode of this show that we've ever done, which is, this is number 60, as well as every single episode of every show on the Gas Digital Network. If you have questions, comments, or your own investigation to submit, send it into MikeVecchioneInvestigates@gmail.com. If you listen on iTunes or YouTube, make sure to rate, review, and tell a friend. And go to podcastmerch.com for t-shirts, hoodies, and mugs. That's it.
And we're working on a new t-shirt, are we not?
We are.
Shannon and Natalie?
Yes, we are working on it.
Okay, so we're gonna try it out ourselves, and then we'll see if it catches, and then we might sell them. But we'll have to see on a trial basis. That's the show. Alia, thank you for coming.
Thanks for having
You've
me.
You've taken your sexy glasses off.
Yeah, no, I'm back to...
You're back to... You just did it for the investigation.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Alia Janine, Shannon, for Natalie, I'm Mike Vecchione. We'll see you guys next week. Guys, thank you for listening to Mike Vecchione Investigates. And if you go to gasdigitalnetwork.com and use promo code MBI, you will get 1 week free. That's gasdigitalnetwork.com, promo code MBI, you will get 1 week free. Thank you again for listening to Mike Vecchione Investigates on the Gas Digital Network.